June 11, 2015, this terrapin, about 1 year old, is fed only prawn meat. And so it won't eat pellets. Now you can see that there is a tail wound. Now this is a male terrapin. The male terrapin, the tail wound is due to being bitten by the other terrapin. So to heal the tail wound, we have applied antibiotics and keep it dry. And to keep it dry 90% of the time, after eating, keep it dry. And he goes home today. He's been here for 3 days. And the wound is dried and healing. You apply cream and wash it. June 11, 2015, Thursday, Singapore. Terrapin with bite wounds. This is quite common when you put two terrapins together. They will bite each other's tail. Hamsters will bite the backside. Dwarf hamsters together, kept together, sometimes bite the backside of each other, especially the dominant one. So it's best to be careful not to put them together, as some of these wounds are hard to heal. You can see the wound is really broad in front of the cool car. Now this is a male. Now to tell whether the terrapin is male or female, the claws are long. The carapace, the lower shell, is concave, and then you can see that the cloaca, there is the cloaca, the vent, is further away from the edge of the lower shell as compared to the female. And so these are the characteristics of male. This is concave. This is definitely concave. And the claws are longer, the front claws are longer. And the other thing is the vent. The vent is further away from the edge of the lower shell. The vent is here, which you can't see because of the wound. And so this is definitely concave. So this is definitely a male terrapin. Bite wounds, top of your vets, Singapore.